Good morning to all of our communities across the Cayman Islands. I wish you all a safe and a happy Easter weekend. As you're aware that today, Easter Sunday, we are in hard curfew, which means a full lockdown throughout the day, which is from 7 p.m. last night until 5 a.m. tomorrow morning. Today, only persons authorised as essential workers are entitled under the law to be out on the roads and away from their homes in the performance of their duties and functions. There is no approved exercise period today as we are in hard curfew. And despite being in hard curfew, so far this morning, 40 persons have been intercepted by police patrols out of their homes on public roads in breach of hard curfew, using the excuse that they were out exercising. All of these persons have been warned for prosecution. Since mid-March, His Excellency the Governor, the Honourable Premier, the Minister for Health, Minister Seymour, and our Chief Medical Officer, Dr. John Lee, have been providing daily media briefings, continuously highlighting the dangers and risks posed by COVID-19 pandemic here in the Cayman Islands. The risks and dangers could not have been highlighted in any stronger fashion. They are here, they are very real, and the risks are very tangible. Yesterday, Dr. Lee reported 8 positive results for the COVID-19 virus, which strongly articulates the dangers of the risk of community transmission of the COVID-19 virus here in the Cayman Islands. This clearly means that we are at a very critical stage as we seek to contain and control the spread of the virus across the Cayman Islands. I think we are all very conscious of the traditions in the Cayman Islands around the Easter bank holiday weekend, particularly as it relates to activities across our public beaches. However, this is not a normal Easter weekend for any of us. We are forced to look at the way business is conducted and how the laws are enforced to prevent the spread of the COVID-19 virus. At the same time, we are conscious of the need for persons to attend to basic needs during this challenging period, as in going to the supermarket, pharmacy, and possibly to the gas station. We understand the need for persons and families to be able to exercise to stay fit and well, but all of this needs to be done in a very controlled and responsible manner. Today, I'm making a special announcement to address the very clear and present risk that prevails here in the communities across the Cayman Islands, articulated by the Governor, the Premier, the Minister and Dr. Lee yesterday in their media briefing. I remind you that we are in hard curfew all day today, Easter Sunday, goes through tonight right through until 5 a.m. in the morning, which means that no person should be away from their home today, and certainly no person should be out exercising or on a public beach in the Cayman Islands. Last night, in consultation with His Excellency the Governor of the Cayman Islands, I issued a curfew order prohibiting access to any public beach across the Cayman Islands during any period on public holiday Easter Monday, tomorrow the 13th of April 2020. To clarify, this position means this curfew is in effect a hard curfew or full lockdown of all public beaches across the Cayman Islands, which prohibits any person or persons from entering, walking, swimming, snorkeling, fishing, exercising or engaging in any type of marine activity on public beaches throughout the Cayman Islands at any time tomorrow, Easter Monday. And this hard curfew will continue and will run until 5 a.m. on Tuesday morning, the 14th of April 2020 at 5 a.m. A public beach means the portion of the beach that ends at the high water mark. This will be of particular interest to persons residing in beachside resorts. I remind all persons that a breach of a hard curfew order is a criminal offence, carrying a penalty of $3,000 Cayman and imprisonment for 1 year or both. And the legal framework for this hard curfew order is contained at Section 49(1) of the Police Law 2017 revision. Tomorrow, Easter Monday, the 13th of April 2020, supermarkets, pharmacies and gas stations will be open and will operate under the terms of the soft curfew. This will allow persons with surnames in the A to K alphabet range to be away from their homes to attend of any of these specified needs. The exercise period not exceeding 90 minutes between the hours of 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. will also be permitted. Food deliveries will also be permitted until 9 p.m. by exempted and authorized restaurant and food outlets. Can I also take this opportunity to mention gatherings in condominium complexes? It is being widely reported that large groups of persons are congregating within community complexes, socializing and drinking in breach of the COVID-19 suppression regulations. In addition to being a criminal offense, it is also a high-risk activity at this critical time as we seek to contain and control the spread of the COVID-19 virus. Our helicopter and marine units will be on extended patrol monitoring marine and ground activities. Police mobile and static patrols will be in place across the islands, monitoring movements of vehicles and persons around the islands. Our ATVs and foot patrols will be on duty on public beaches to impose the hard curfew order. I appeal to all of our communities to work within the requirements of the soft and hard curfews as we seek to protect lives at this critical and challenging time. And I thank you.